Ladies and gentlemen, can you feel that breeze? I am so glad to see you're back here for another round of music you'll wish you've never heard. This time, we will be exploring some of the world's most disturbing, bizarre, and downright shocking artists. So grab your coat and let's go. Welcome to the Deep Music Iceberg, Shock Artists Edition. As always, tears are arbitrary, and constructive criticism is always welcome. Level 1. Notorious and Infamous. Artists featured in this tier have reached a level of notoriety and influence on popular music that has allowed them to fully cross over in the mainstream, desensitizing most people who engage with their content on a superficial basis. Kiss was a glam metal band that became extremely popular in the mid-70s because of their signature face paint and edgy costumes. During live performances, bassist Gene Simmons would breathe fire and spit blood. Impressive pyrotechnics became a massive selling point for the band's concerts, with instruments smoking and levitating and shooting rockets. Often dubbed as the first metal band, though that is debatable, Black Sabbath was a band that undoubtedly shocked the early 70s with their horror-themed lyrics, nods to Satanism, and down-tuned, ominous guitars. Lead vocalist Ozzy Osbourne is perhaps best remembered for biting the head off of a dead bat in 1982 at a solo gig when a fan threw it on stage and he thought it was a rubber toy. Slayer is one of the most iconic thrash metal bands in music history, and not without reason, known for their extremely fast riffs. The band has allegedly been affiliated with far-right ideologies and Satanism, but denies any involvement to this day. Their 2006 album, Christ Illusion, caused controversy with its cover that depicted a mutilated Christ figure, and featuring the song Jihad, which is about the September 11 attacks, from the perspective of a hijacker. Pioneering Neue Deutsche Harte in 1994, German dance metal band Rammstein are known for their bombastic pyrotechnic shows that occasionally injured their audience. While they managed to get away with featuring hardcore adult content in their music videos in Germany, that wasn't the case in America. When they joined Korn, Limp Bizkit, Ice Cube, and Incubus for the 1998 Family Values Tour, they got arrested on stage for indecent exposure. After showing up for the Halloween show, barely wearing anything. Korn is a California band that can be credited with popularizing nu metal since their formation in 1993. One of their music videos involved a pimp and a group of call girls running over the members of the band. Jonathan Davis, the band's frontman, also famously worked as a mortician and coroner before becoming a rock star. Slipknot is a Midwestern nu metal band formed in 1995 during the heyday of rap metal, standing out with their mysterious and aggressive stage antics. All members perform in grotesque homemade Halloween masks and identical jumpsuits, allowing them to originally remain anonymous. Their music has inspired a South African 16-year-old to fatally attack a classmate in 2008, as well as a grave robbery in 2006. Although potentially most disturbing was lead vocalist Corey Taylor's appearance in Nostalgia Critic's The Wall movie review in 2019. Marilyn Manson is the name of Brian Hugh Warner's stage persona in the alt-industrial band he plays in, which he founded in 1989. Manson is mostly known for his use of Satanist imagery. He was made a reverend in 1994, injuring himself on stage with pocket knives and broken bottles, and being arrested for performing provocative acts in front of crowds. NIN, aka Nine Inch Nails, is an American band most often credited with bringing the industrial rock sound to the mainstream in the early 90s. Apart from their explicit lyrics and harsh instrumentations, frontman and main actor Trent Reznor is known to have unknowingly stayed at Sharon Tate's mansion, where the actress had been murdered by the Manson family in the 1960s. The 1992 short film that was supposed to come out alongside the Broken EP was thought of as a snuff film because of its graphic execution opener. And miraculously and most bizarrely, a video camera that had literally floated away tied to a balloon during the filming of a video for the album Down In It was recovered by a farmer, who brought it to the FBI and thought to have recorded a deceased Trent Reznor in yet another snuff film, which was obviously not the case. Johan Van Roy has been performing as Suicide Commando since the mid-1980s, pioneering European electro-industrial music oozing darkness. Sinister melodies were coupled with violent imagery and lyrical references to serial killers, which flash on stage during live performances. Gore is the name of an American heavy metal band that is known for the unique lore surrounding their projects. The group performs in elaborate sci-fi costumes as barbaric interplanetary warriors. During their shows, they reference popular figures of the time and perform shocking stunts that often result in crowds leaving shows covered in fake blood. The Caretaker is the name of one of Leyland Kirby's electronic projects. Initially inspired by 30s ballroom pop, he began by remixing samples of old records, with releases becoming more conceptual as his sound evolved. His latest and final project, Everywhere at the End of Time, became a worldwide phenomenon. It is a series of 6 albums which sonically depict the decay of memory and cognition as a result of dementia, starting from big band jazz remixes which gradually become corroded into minimal ambient. Vocalist John S. Hall has fronted several incarnations of the alternative comedy rock band he formed in 1986, King Missile. Their records are mostly made up of vulgar spoken word musings and comedic outtakes. They had a minor hit with their 1992 lead single. Level 2. Great Contrarians. These infamous underground shock stars have reached celebrity status within their own niche, and despite not appealing to the mainstream, have earned the respect of many music aficionados. To some, Steve Roden is more of a sound artist than a musician. He was one of the first Americans to dabble in lowercase music, amplifying quiet sounds into audible frequencies and using them as sonic compositions. In 2001, the Los Angeles Public Library commissioned him to record Forms of Paper for an exhibition. The album is entirely made up of distorted sounds of paper being handled. Kikuo is a Japanese vocal aid producer who became famous for utilizing the innocence associated with sweet Japanese pop to pair it with surprisingly dark-themed lyrics. Complex time signatures and jazzy rhythms make his music all the more cheerful to the unassuming listener, for a truly shocking revelation to all curious non-Japanese speakers who look up the lyrics. The duo composed of instrumentalist Martin Rev and vocalist Alan Vega were pioneers of punk music, being one of the first bands to use the term in 1970. Initially disliked by crowds, ridiculed by peers, and loathed by critics, Suicide went on to become one of the most influential proto-industrial electronic acts of all time. Their debut self-titled album, Suicide, contained a number of eerie, hypnotic, minimalist electronica tracks and provocative lyrics. From the frantic, erotic moans of Girl to the 10-minute spiral into insanity tale of Frankie Teardrop. Producer Turk Dietrich and guitarist Michael Jones are Belong, a New Orleans-based drone ambient duo who craft dense guitar-generated walls of sound with thick, noisy atmospheres and remarkably simple melodies. They were mostly active during the late 2000s and early 2010s, with their last album, Common Era, released in 2011. Aaron Funk is a Canadian electronic musician who has been performing his Venetian snares since 1992. He is a prolific pioneer of breakcore, a form of EDM known for its chopped, abrasive breakbeats, complex time signatures, and chaotic, noisy samples. He has 27 full-length albums out and over 30 singles and EPs featuring explicit titles. Stephen Stapleton began performing as Nurse with Wound as a band in 1978, before becoming a solo project. Influenced by Dada and Surrealism, NWW has explored a number of genres through the use of tape loops, releasing more than 40 albums. Originally a grindcore band, Daughters is an industrial no-wave band that rose to critical acclaim after the release of their 2018 album, You Won't Get What You Want, the first to be released after their breakup in 2009. With hypnotic beats and abrasive metallic drums, the repetitive drones of the lyrics and sampled shrieks that adorned the album make it the ideal stepping stone for many into darker, more experimental releases. Probably one of the most divisive bands in rock music history, Swans have been experimenting with their sound since their inception in 1982, going from noisy no wave to industrial post-punk to field recordings and post-rock soundscapes. The reputation for disturbing music persists in time, with some of their most haywire early releases boasting names like Filth, and public castration is always a good idea. They are known to escalate relatively quiet songs into cacophonous crescendos and writing disturbing lyrics like Volcano, which was written from the perspective of a psychopath stalking and cannibalizing a rock star. Most recently, their 2014 song She Loves Us has become somewhat infamous for its explicit chorus. Originally a performance art group known as Comb Transmissions, Throbbing Crystal later evolved to be a band mostly known for pioneering industrial music in the late 70s. They released their material on their own label, Industrial Records, where they had complete freedom to tackle controversial references. One of their original members, Cozy Fanny Tootie, was a stripper and adult model, with her explicit work featured in the group's exhibitions. Founder Genesis Porridge died in 2020, and fellow member Peter Christopherson went on to form another band, Quail. Quail was an experimental band formed in 1982 with goth neo-folk and dark ambient influences on their post-industrial sounds, which were riddled with edgy references to sensuality and the occult. While their first release was in 1985, they didn't actually perform live until 1999. In 2004, co-founder John Balance died, and Peter Christopherson released the band's last album, The Ape of Naples, a collection of material recorded from 1993 to 2004 to critical acclaim. Christopherson passed away in 2010. Discussed in our previous disturbing music Iceberg, this mysterious act has been the object of attention due to their propensity to feature the crying and screaming of children and mental patients on their albums. Some have dubbed it the sound of hell. Jesus Christ Allen, better known as Gigi Allen, was a shock rock punk rocker who was known for his scandalous performances. Gigi took laxatives so he could relieve himself on stage and threw it at the audience, and would perform naked, ending most of his shows smeared in bodily fluids and injured. While he originally planned on taking his life on stage, after what ended up being his last gig, he walked on the streets in a dazed, grimy state and then OD'd on heroin. His will stated that he was not to be washed before his funeral, and that fans could pose and disfigure his body with drugs and alcohol during the ceremony. It was then released on DVD and VHS to all his fans. Wolf Eyes are an experimental band that was formed in 1996 and became one of the most prominent protagonists of the late 90s noise scene. They have released more than 120 albums which catalog their grating industrial noise improvisations. Their music is an onslaught of harsh sounds, screamed vocals, and off-kilter beats. Named after the Plateau of Darkness in the Land of Mordor from The Lord of the Rings, Gorgoroth is a satanic Norwegian black metal band that was rumored to have started after lead guitarist Infernus made a deal with the devil. They rose to fame due to their shocking live performances. For instance, while playing in Poland, they brought on 4 naked crucifixes, several impaled sheep heads, and an alleged 80 liters of sheep's blood to the stage. This resulted in them getting arrested, but subsequently let go when they claimed they did not know that this was illegal. They recreated this concert in the music video for their song Carving a Giant. Mayhem is a black metal band from Norway that formed in 1984. They were one of the most notorious original players in the Norwegian black metal scene, going as far as to influence the Norwegian church burnings. During their infamous concerts, lead vocalist Dead would cut himself with knives and glass, and the band would impale pig and sheep heads in front of their stage. Dead tragically took his life in 1991, after which fellow member and guitarist Euronymous took pictures of his body and used one for the bootleg album cover Dawn of the Black Hearts. 2 years later, band rival and former member Varg Vikernes stabbed Euronymous to death. He served 15 years in prison and was released in 2009. AC was a grindcore, noisecore, and hardcore band formed in 1993, improvising loud and fast music during live shows. They bypassed their band name being censored on their album art through evocative typography. Despite their numerous lineup changes and eventual switch into written songs and lyrics, they never had a bass player. Their lyrics routinely reference offensive themes, but they admitted to doing this for the purpose of shocking reviewers they'd send their material to draw attention to themselves. They disbanded in 2011, when lead singer Seth Putnam suffered a heart attack. In 2018, lead guitarist Josh Martin also died in a freak accident when he fell off of an escalator and hit his head on a table at the Providence Place Mall. Jandek is the name of a mysterious lo-fi blues folk music project which began releasing music through their own label, Corewood Industries, in 1978. For over 30 years, the man behind Jandek was an enigma, with only a handful of authorized interviews ever revealing anything about his life. While his name was revealed to be Sterling Richard Smith upon the release of the debut album, the only known anecdote about his life was that at one point, he wrote 7 novels but burnt them all when they were rejected by New York publishers. In 2004, he was finally revealed to be the same man who appeared in the record sleeves of his albums when he finally performed in public. They were a late 70s punk rock band based in Los Angeles and known for their goofy parodic style and growly vocal delivery of classics such as I Wanna Punch You in the Face. Extracted from their only album, the legendary Brown Album, a spoof of the Beatles' White Album, released 8 years after the band disbanded in 1994. Level 3. Inglorious Bastards. The music produced by artists in this tier begins to lose emphasis on melody and instead focuses on creating chaotic, hostile atmospheres that only the bravest can bear. Japanese noise musician Masami Akita began performing his Merzbow as early as 1979, and quickly gained massive popularity for his particularly aggressive brand of harsh noise. Born out of his revolutionary use of distortion, feedback, and various machinery of homemade noisemakers. Hanada rash is a word that means snot-nosed in Japanese, as well as the name of a chaotic 80s noise band formed by Yamantaka Ai, who then went on to achieve worldwide fame through space rock psychedelic band Boredoms. Hanada rash is best known for their scandalous live shows, which the audience had to sign forms before attending, agreeing to the possibility of being harmed during the gig. Shows routinely included animal mutilation, self-mutilation, and even operating heavy machinery like bulldozers through the stage. The band was eventually forbidden to perform in most venues across Japan. A punk band from Tampa, AT specialized in writing mostly humorous comedy songs about flatulence, genitalia, and, surprisingly enough, Eric Roberts. Originally known as Chemical Dependency, MS are a gore-grind noisecore band which has been active since the early 90s in California, led by a man known as Robert Deathrage. Their first demo was notorious for featuring over 100 extremely offensive and profane songs. Allegedly, a waitress collapsed as a result of Deathrage's stage banter and died on the way to the hospital during the group's second gig. As of 2010, Deathrage was working as a janitor. Marco Corbelli was an Italian musician who released lo-fi noise music under the moniker of Atrix Morg through his own label, Slaughterhouse Productions, and sometimes collaborating with other noise labels like Self Abuse Records. His tapes remained mostly underground releases of sadistic industrial spurts, secretions of bodily fluids converted into noise. Corbelli tragically took his life in 2007. Japanese noise musician and actor Masaya Nakahara is perhaps best known as Violent Onsen Geisha or Hairstylistics. He began making music in the 1980s and quickly piqued the interest of Sonic Youth and Beck. His music often sampled a number of noises through loops and collages to create intriguing and unsettling soundscapes as well as ear-piercing noise compositions. Later releases like 2014's Dynamic Hate have seen a shift to more melodic beats. Nakahara has also been a novelist and a film critic. Wet House were an English 80s band credited with starting the power electronic subgenre of industrial music. Their concerts were extremely controversial for their heavy use of sadism and abrasive sounds with needling high frequencies and ferocious washes of white noise. And, of course, their infamous enraged lyrics. The Nublicators were a harsh noise band that became popular in the early days of the genre along with White House and Throbbing Gristle. Unlike the other bands, though, they endeavor to remain anonymous throughout their career, rarely appearing in public and always wearing masks when doing so. Most of their music is defined by the use of metallic grating sounds and analog feedback. Swift Trukey, better known as his alias, is an Australian speedcore and breakcore musician who has gained notoriety because of his blend of noisy horrorcore and hardcore. Fast beats, catchy melodies, chirpy shrieking vocals, and vulgar lyrics are the hallmark of his sounds. In addition to featuring explicit album art, he is also a painter who frequently utilizes it as a subject for his work. Danny Devos, aka DDV, is a Belgian artist and member of the pioneering noise industrial band Club Moral. Devos' performance art typically deals with true crime themes, for which he has been in correspondence with serial killer John Wayne Gacy, amongst others. His records often feature screeching noises, chopped up sampled vocals, and tape hiss. Italian noise aficionados Pierpaolo Zoppo and Maurizio Bianchi were a musical group called Metalsin Orchestra, which became one of the biggest early industrial and power electronics pioneers in the country. Along with brutal noise collages, their music explored extreme perversions, mistreatment, and disease, along with grotesque high-pitched vocals. Emil Beaulieu, America's greatest living noise artist, real name Ron Lessard, is a prolific original noise artist who famously performs with a Minutoli, a custom-made four-armed turntable, created by his friend and named after him. Beaulieu has performed with noise superstars like Merz Bowen and was one of the first artists who have manually altered his records by melting, drilling, and painting them in order to degrade the sound into just mere noise, which has since been called the anti-record. Eric Lund is a noise musician perhaps best known for being part of the industrial 80s band Boy Dirt Car. Lund went on to release a few solo records ranging from noise to distorted tape compositions and wrote a book before reuniting with Boy Dirt Car in 2008 to make more music with industrial instrumentation from scrapyards and roadsides. Level 4. Scandalous Suspects. Far down enough to make the average person shudder, shock plays a major role in the career of these artists, who are only truly loved and enjoyed by select niche pockets of the internet. Juntari Yamanuchi's project, the Garogari Gikiki, started in 1985 and has been largely associated with Japanese harsh noise thanks to his popular Power Electronics 1990 release. He was also able to record more straightforward punk material and even a few ambient releases. While initially a group, the penchant of one of the members to pleasure himself on stage led the project to become more of a solo effort over time. Conceptual releases featured actual recordings of couples being intimate while the Japanese national anthem played in the background and assorted bowel movements. After the release of their 2001 album, the band became inactive, to only return in 2016. One of the first industrial musicians to join Throbbing Gristle and Industrial Records, Monte Cazaz's career has been characterized by shock performances to mixed reception in the late 70s. He defiled religious statues and created sculptures of far-right symbols and roadkill. He was also a prolific film and photography artist, taking a picture of himself in an electric chair the day that Gary Gilmore was executed for murder. A Hong Kong newspaper accidentally printed his image instead of Gilmore's on the day of the real execution, while reporting the news. HH is the solo gore project of Morris of previous band fame, which began in 2005 out of a perverse fascination with gore grind music. Releases feature raw, filthy, downturned music and growled vocals, most often dealing with themes related to SA. Miko Aspa is a vocalist in several black metal projects, as well as the owner of two record labels and the publisher of an adult magazine and video series, who also releases noise industrial music as Nicole 12. The project was born out of a desire to denounce the objectification of young girls, and often features repetitive vocals along with harsh instrumentation. Scott Hall, who briefly played in AC and is mostly known for being part of another grindcore band, is also a member of Japanese Torture Comedy Hour, a harsh noise grindcore blend of relentless assaults of screaming electronic madness and maddening static explosions that is still active today. DR is a gore grind Czech band known for its fast drum beats and shock horror sampling that was active in the mid to late 2000s. Most notably, their album Sister's Menstruation begins with an audible scream sample which is evocative of the album cover chosen for the record. Macroninfa is a power electronics noise band which began performing in the early 90s, led by Joseph Romer. While Macroninfa's trademark sound, a collage of metal junk bashed against each other, layered and looped utilizing mostly analog equipment, is not too different from that of their contemporaries, the controversial themes of their compositions remain the object of upset. They describe their 1995 album, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, as a critical determination of genetic malfunction in three racial groups, with every race being a track. Australian power electronics noise musician Alex Zane is known for his participation in a number of bands and releases within the scene, using the name Goldenrod in 1995 to release three tapes. He is perhaps best known for his participation as Pure Filth and Striker. Not much is known about Body Inflation Sequence, the depressive harsh electronic king of Austin, Texas, who has been active in the local scene since the early 2010s with dozens of self-released Bandcamp offerings of his particularly elastic and provocative brand of noise and feedback loops. David Jackman is an English experimental drone musician who began releasing his material under the name Organum in 1983, distributing cassettes and vinyls on various labels around Europe through short EPs and single compositions. While he rarely performs in interviews, he has collaborated with Nurse with Wound and the New Blockaders, amongst many other noise artists. Level 5. Wicked, Evil, and Vile. Legend and mystery surrounds these artists, who make grating and accessible music charged with taboo themes and perverse imagery. This band specializes in harsh noise and death electronics straight from the bowels of Southern California. They have been self-releasing music on Bandcamp since 2014. While their graphic imagery and titles may be more evocative of the body horror of chord noise, the sound of their releases is a particularly thick and ominous brand of harsh noise. Tugosrao is a relatively new chord noise band. Their releases fall within a subgenre that has a more rudimentary quality and seemingly random processed noises used to create cacophonous, abrasive atmospheres. Named after Francis Bacon's macabre 1954 painting, Figure with Meat is a band that infuses the power electronics noise sound with hints of dark ambient and vaporwave. Their sound is extremely harsh and uses ear-piercing high frequencies, so listen with caution. Named after the procedure which transplants patches of skin from one region of the body to another, Wyatt Howland performs under the alias Skin Graft, producing harsh noise music. Previously a member of grindcore outfit Apartment 213, Skin Graft's discography is almost endless, dating back to the late 2000s and producing a number of scratchy, screechy waves of big Christian noise. Starting from the early 90s, Skin Crime has become a known name in the atmospheric noise scene, fusing musique concrète with Japanese noise. They began as the side project of Self-Abuse Records creator Patrick O'Neill, and unlike most harsh noise bands, Skin Crime featured a full lineup during live performances. Parodying then-popular female pop duo Mel and Kim, Smell and Quim is an English improvised noise collective that has been performing since 1987. Their music often deals with taboo themes, and their live shows are not any less scandalous as they perform with costumes and masks and enact lewd acts on stage. During a concert in 2007, they mutilated a pig's head on stage and attempted to set it on fire, leading to the entire cancellation of the Deaf Forever festival they were performing in. Started in 2007 as a tribute to Atrix Morgue, Stab Electronics is a power electronics band from the UK. Their releases focus on paranoia, depression, anxiety, and perversion amidst a backdrop of grating harsh noise. A grindcore duo known for their graphic costumes where they cosplay as blood-covered mutants, AHC is made up of El Bukake and El Fuko. Most of their songs don't hit the 2-minute mark and are brutal to the point of attacking morality with the addition of clever audio samples. They are possibly best known for their gurgled water vocal delivery, which has earned them the reputation of becoming the world's first true bong metal band. Peter Sotos is probably best known for his spoken word albums and books, where he examines SA and takes on the first-person role of the perpetrator exploring sadistic perverse impulses and CP. He also uses interviews with criminals to compose a disturbing, realistic narrative. Because he utilized covers for his zines taken from real, graphic, explicit magazines, he was eventually arrested and had to plead guilty for possession of CP. Level 6. Who? On top of being mostly inaccessible other than to a select few, these artists are shrouded in mystery because of their obscurity, lost in a haze of darkness and depravity. Brent Field performs as EBDVI, a lo-fi outsider project focusing on bizarre recordings and tape manipulations. Many of the tracks included in his records can be seen performed in mysterious YouTube videos where Field appears to be wearing masks and playing a number of improvised instruments. The alias of Vlado Ketch, VXXKXX or Venom88888, used to release music on the now defunct Sick Mode Records. He utilized tape music to exaggerate, mutate, and manipulate what has come before and what come in the future. His tapes create bouts of terror and noise through lo-fi tape hoops and digital hardcore. One of his most popular releases, Terror Blog Volume 1, sampled dictatorial speeches. Gabriele Giuliani, also known as Alzheimer TV, Discordant Strift, and Olioris in Capsicum, as well as DBL, is an Italian harsh noise musician who was most prolific in the early 90s, using his numerous aliases to dabble in a number of extreme genres. His hellish distortion blended nihilism with violence, making him one of the masters of Italian noise. David DeCarm and Jesse Kling's duo is a power electronics outfit mostly known for its depictions of women in precarious positions in their album Art and Explicit Music. Their metallic releases included sludgy guitar tones and sometimes field recordings of animal noises and shouted vocals, often detailing questionable encounters. Nicola Vinciguerra is a noise artist who runs the Italian branch of the harsh noise no-fi punk label Tortured Animal. Vinciguerra is also a visual artist who makes adult and explicit prints on his website with references to medical horror and gore. Another Tortured Animal signee is 12-year-old Proud Parent, the duo made up of Richard Ramirez and George Proctor, also known as Mutant Ape. They were active from 2007 to 2010, making harsh noise and experimental releases crudely depicting teenage pregnancy. Crippling Self-Doubt is the aptly named alias of Scott Dryman, documenting his journey through failed relationships, self-loathing, and never-ending failure. Through experimental noise and collaged sound, lo-fi samples, and atonal bleeps. Most of Dryman's work is comprised of altered spoken word samples and uneasy instrumentals, which create a constant feeling of discomfort and, well, crippling self-doubt. Anthony Shaw has a number of aliases under his belt, including Albert Fish is My Hero, a name which glorifies American serial killer and cannibal Albert Fish. On top of being a depraved noise artist, he also operates the record labels Dumping Ground Recordings and Life is Easy. His 2006 concept album, Eileen, is a power electronics harsh noise hybrid, which oftentimes samples the interview audio from serial killer Eileen Warnes. John Duncan is an American multimedia artist who currently lives in Italy and focuses his body of work in shortwave radio recordings and confrontational pieces. Perhaps the most disturbing is 1980s Blind Date, in which he can be heard having what he claims were intimate relations with a deceased person, in an effort to torture himself physically and psychically because his vasectomy was not enough. The anonymous alias of the most depraved and mysterious uploader to ever drop an album on 4chan's music board Mew is Zenjin. Yet. Should we dive in again? Let us know below. We wanted to take a moment to thank our growing community for the repeated support you have shown us here at Sets in the CD. Like, subscribe, and share the video, and follow us on Twitter and Medium to keep up with the development of our projects. We have so much more in store and cannot wait to bring you more stories from behind the music.